So, in Starfield, there is a lot to explore, there's a lot to do, and I've played a few hours of the game now, and I've noticed I've started making a lot of mistakes already. So what we're going to do in this video is go through 7 big Starfield mistakes that you're probably still making, and some of you are going to see these as more tips and tricks, and this isn't to say you're a bad player, this is based on mistakes I've made to try and help you guys avoid making the same mistakes. So number one, I'm going to say, is looting the small bits. If we roam around our ship, you'll see little things here, like there's a pot and it's got a value of 8. And there's, for an example, a kitchen tea steeper and it's got a value of 5. I started the game off picking a load of these up, but when you go to sell them, you don't actually get the value for them. If I still have it in my inventory, there is a note. Like here, for an example, there's Moby Dick and it's got a value of 590. But if we jump off the ship quickly and if we make our way over to this selling kiosk, we go down to the notes and we try to sell it, we're only actually going to get 81. There is a skill called Commerce. You buy for 5% less and you sell for 10% more. But you have to do a bunch of challenges to level this up, and when you get it to the max rank, you'll be able to buy for 20% less and sell for 25% more, but that's going to take you a long time to do. So at the start of the game, at least, I wouldn't pick up any of the small bits. If it's got a value of over like 1,000, I'd probably pick it up, because that's a good like 100 plus credits each item. But picking up all the little bits is just going to build up your mass, is going to over-encumber you, and it just gets really stressful with oxygen and stuff when you're over-encumbered. Missions and just general progression rewards in this game are so much more than looting the little bits. I mean, obviously, if you find a weapon crate or something like that, go for it. But I wouldn't pick up the small bits that are just lying around. It's just completely pointless. Number two is not unlocking the lockpicking skill. This is a massive mistake in my opinion, as you might come across quests that have doors that are locked behind a master lock, and if you don't have the right skill, you can't actually complete that quest. Not only that, in the lodge, if I go downstairs into the quarters where all the workbenches and stuff are, there is a spacesuit that I really want to get my hands on, but in order to get my hands on it, I need to have master level locks available to pick, and that is a rank 3. So as soon as you get a point, I would recommend putting it into lockpicking under the tech tab, like it's a security skill. I highly, highly recommend doing it. I'm going to say it's a mistake if you don't unlock it, because lockpicking is really, really common and the rewards are incredible from it. Then number three is a lack of inventory management. If we go into our character, if we go to the inventory, my mass is currently a 53 out of 135. If you're going around picking up little bits, or you just have a bunch of weapons and stuff that you've looted off enemies, your mass is going to very quickly build up. You will become over-encumbered, your oxygen is going to deplete a lot faster. So I highly recommend every now and then jump into your inventory, sort it out, because you do have a robot companion, at least at the start of the game, called Vasco, even though I have no idea where Vasco's gone. But you can trade with Vasco and he's going to hold stuff for you. But not only that, if you go into your pause menu and you go down to the ship, if you look at the bottom right, there's a prompt to press X and go into the cargo hold. This way, what you can do is if we press left bumper and go to inventory, we can take stuff out of our inventory that we don't want to carry. So if I didn't want to carry this note, I can then go and store it and it goes into the Frontier's cargo. And if you have a look, if we just go back into this quickly and we go to the Frontier, you'll see the mass is 185 out of 450, so you can carry a lot more on your ship compared to what you can on your character. But not only that, when you join the Constellation not too far into the game, you're going to get your own storage locker in your lodge room. And as mentioned, you start losing oxygen very, very fast when you're over-encumbered, so I highly recommend sorting out your inventory. The mistake number four is spending your credits on rubbish. There are a bunch of different things to buy in Starfield, and within the first couple of hours, you're going to see things like, if we talk to this guy, and we go down to let me see what ships you have for sale, not only that, it's going to cost you 1,000 to repair your ship. If we go in here, you'll see at the bottom left the value. If we go along, for an example, we go to the final ship, Shieldbreaker is 265,000. But that's with me having a point in commerce, so I've got 5% less. It's like a 270,000 credit ship. But not only that, you can upgrade your own ship, you can hire crew members, there's a lot of different stuff you can do in the game, and it gets expensive. So I wouldn't go around buying random stuff and wasting money on things you don't need unless you want to just wait a lot longer to get something that you might find that's really valuable to you a bit further into the game. And then mistake number 5 is stealing stuff. It's not always a mistake, especially if you want to be naughty in the game. And contraband, at least from what I've found, is incredibly valuable. I think the value of the contraband I picked up was about 12 or 13,000 credits. You're obviously not going to get that much if you sell it, but you'll get a good few thousand from one item. It's really, really valuable, but when you go to certain planets, like if you come to New Atlantis on Alpha Centauri or whatever the planet is called, when you go to New Atlantis or at least enter the system or the planet area or whatever, your ship is going to be scanned. And if you are caught with contraband, it's going to be taken off you. So you've got to be really, really sneaky when you've got contraband. And I personally think it's a mistake to go around stealing stuff. It's just, it's so risky, it's pointless, it's a waste of time. You might as well progress with missions and stuff to earn the credits because it's going to happen a lot faster and you don't need to be so careful. But if you do want to, you can also unlock pickpocketing from the skill tree. So right there under the social tab, you'll see theft. It unlocks the ability to pickpocket targets. And if you're wanting to go down the naughty or the thief route for quick credits, then absolutely go for it. But it's risky, you need to be really careful. So I'm going to put stealing stuff as a mistake. Then mistake number 6 is not using mission boards. If we go into the viewport, there is going to be a mission board in here. So if we have a look at the mission board, there are a bunch of different missions you can take on. Like for an example, we can go and destroy a Crimson Fleet. We can deliver some resonators. We can transport settlers. There are lots and lots of different missions available. There are multiple mission boards. There's even one in the lodge. And if you have a look at the rewards, they're offering at the bare minimum 1,700, but all the way up to 9,400 credits for a mission. So they offer really, really good credits. And some of the missions are like crazy easy, like really, really easy to complete. But not only that, if you just accept all of these, you don't need to focus on them. You can take every single one that's available. You're not limited to how many you can have as far as I'm aware. But some of them will, like, eventually, because this does restock these mission boards, some of them will require specific things like having a huge cargo capacity on your ship. So even if you don't focus on them specifically, accept them all, because you can just do them over time as you're playing. If you don't go to mission boards and you don't accept them, then you're missing out on the extra credits. Some of them are as simple as surveying certain planets, and that's all tied into the exploration. So I highly recommend just picking them up, even if you don't do them for a very long time, because you could be in the middle of a main mission or something, come across one of these side missions, and you're going to get extra credits. And then last but definitely not least is focusing on just the main missions. Starfield has a lot to do, from side quests to surveying planets and much more. Don't just focus on the main missions, because the side missions often have very good rewards. They're also going to help you discover more of the game. I did a mission board mission. It took me through multiple different planets to take down some enemies in space combat. And after getting to enjoy some fighting in space, I got a bunch of credits. So I got exploration, combat, credits. It's 100% worth mixing it all up. Not just doing the same thing of focusing on the main story. Because I would say, in my opinion, this game's not just a rush to the finish line. I would recommend taking your time with it. I'm absolutely loving this game. And Starfield's also got New Game Plus. There are a bunch of different skills to unlock, so loads of levels, and there's lots and lots of planets to explore as well. So if you enjoy this game in any capacity, then I would not focus specifically on the main storyline. And that is 7 big Starfield mistakes you're probably still making. And on that note, we are going to leave the video there. If you enjoyed it, leaving a like is appreciated. If you wish to support me further as a creator, there are links in the description. Let me know your thoughts about the video in the comments. And if you want to watch more, you can click the video on screen. All support on the channel is greatly appreciated, and I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching.